Vn. Capacitance of the spherical capacitor is 4 pi epsilon by 1 by A minus 1 by B. So if you have a single sphere, the other sphere you assume that it is at infinity. Capacitance of isolated sphere, the other sphere you assume that it is at R equal to infinity. So if B is infinity, if B is infinity, 1 by infinity tends to 0. So 4 pi epsilon A. So the expression for capacitance of an isolated sphere is 4 pi epsilon A. Then there are two kinds of problems that you are getting. In capacitance, you are getting two kinds of problems. One kind of problem is telling there is a capacitor with separation D1. Now the separation is doubled. So if the separation is doubled, what happens to the voltage in the second case, assuming charge is not disturbed? That is one kind of problem. Another kind of problem, the separation is increased, assuming energy to be the same, what will happen? So sometimes in the problems they are giving Q1 equal to Q2, then C1V1 is C2V2. Then in this they will ask some ratio V2 by V1 like that. So sometimes they say a sheet is inserted. First case the capacitor has air as dielectric. Second case a micro is inserted with epsilon r equal to 10. Then second case epsilon r will become 10. So you have to use this equation, find out V2 by V1. Or if they say energies are equal, then you have to use this equation and find out V2 by V. So if they ask, if they give the hint to assume charge remains same, use this and then calculate V2 by V. If they give a hint saying that energy is not disturbed, then use this equation and calculate V2 by V. Electrostatic boundary conditions, when flux lines go through the boundary, they get diffracted. Example, porcelain air boundary. You find on the road, you find transformer has insulator. Above the insulator, air is there. Insulator of transformer is made of porcelain. So surface of the porcelain insulator is porcelain air boundary. And in your classroom, you have glass wood boundary. In your classroom, your board is made of glass, and the frame is made of wood. So there is a boundary between the surface of the glass and the wood. You have glass wood boundary. So glass wood boundary, two boundary conditions. Dn1 is Dn2, Et1 is Et2. So if you expand, D1 cos theta 1 is D2 cos theta 2. So in short questions, out of the four variables, three will be given. Theta 1, theta 2, D1 given. Find out flux density in medium 2. Or Et1 sin theta 1 is E2, E1 sin theta 1 is E2 sin theta 2. So here theta 1, theta 2, E2, E1 given, you have to find out the other term. And this equation is called Snell's law. Tan theta 2 by tan theta 1 is epsilon r 2 by epsilon r 1. This equation is called Snell's equation, or this law is called Snell's law. So they will give a porcelain air boundary. There is a porcelain air boundary. Epsilon r of porcelain is 100. Angle of incidence is 30 degrees. Find out angle of emergence. So when they say porcelain air boundary, you should understand that air epsilon r 1 is 1. It will not be given what is epsilon r of air. It should come from your memory. Then the porcelain epsilon r is given, one angle is given, you have to calculate the other angle using Snell's law. Then you have objective questions on force of attraction between plates. When two capacitor plates are there, one is positively charged, the other one is negatively charged. Between the two plates, you have force of attraction. So that force of attraction, half epsilon E square, where epsilon is epsilon 0, epsilon r into E square. So in one of the examination, he has asked, a mica slab is inserted with epsilon r equal to 10. What will be the force in the second case? So when a mica sheet of epsilon r equal to 10 is inserted, the force increases by 10 times, because force is directly proportional to epsilon. This is your So divergence of epsilon E is rho. Then del square V is rho by epsilon. So rho is del square V divided del square V into epsilon. But epsilon should come here. So if potential is given, if you are asked to find out rho, in your problem potential is given, you are asked to find out rho. If potential is given, you are asked to find out rho. So find out del square V and then multiply with epsilon, you will get. Or if electric field is given, you are asked to find out rho and take epsilon E, then take divergence, you will get rho. So these are the two kinds of problems you can expect. If electric field is given, multiply with epsilon, take divergence of that, that will be your rho. If potential is given, then find out del square V, multiply that with epsilon, then you will get. So one match the following which I took from your examination. So now you have to match and tell me the answer. So what is A corresponding to? Gauss law, can you identify in that? A corresponds to 4, that equal to rho, Poisson's equation. Del square V equal to minus rho by epsilon. Laplace equation, del square V is equal to. So I am giving you this equation to question to tell you from each chapter you will have at least like this some 2 or 3. So in your competitive examination, they are not just asking one equation, they are asking set of equations. You have to match the law with the corresponding equation. That's why you have to prepare charts of formulae and keep those charts in your room so that you can answer this type of questions. For every subject, you have to prepare formulae charts, laws, etc. and remember them so that you can answer this type of question. Out of the 4, if you know 3, 4th one you can get it by logic. So that is the advantage in multiple choice. Out of the 4, you may know 3, then 4th one will come by logic. Magnetics. So magnetics deals with the magnetic field produced by conductors, static current or steady current. Steady current means DC current. So when static current flows through the conductor, magnetic field is produced. Magnetic field at the center of the circular loop, if I have a circular loop at the center of the circular loop, it is I by 2E. So they are giving current value, they are giving radius of the circular loop. They are asking you to find out magnetic field at the center of the circle. First Maxwell, second Maxwell's equation by Savart's law. So second Maxwell's equation, which is the field form of by Savart's law, is a straight conductor. This experiment you can do, you take a paper, throw iron dust. So if you take a conductor and you throw iron dust, that will take the shape of concentric circles. So your magnetic field will be in the form of concentric circles. Flux entering and flux leaving are equal. So if the flux entering this volume and flux leaving are equal, then net flux is 0 divided by delta V. Phi by delta V, net outflow of flux by volume is dy V, so dy V is 0. This equation is second Maxwell's equation or field form of by Savart's law. Dy V equal to 0 is field form of by Savart's law. There is a meaning for this equation. What is the meaning for dy V equal to rho? Dy V equal to rho in electrostatics, rho is called source function. So from the positively charged, flux will start and flux will terminate at the negative charge. From the positively charged body, flux starts and terminates at the negative charge. So you have isolated positive charge, isolated negative charge. But in magnetics, there is nothing like a source or nothing like a sink. If there is something called isolated north pole and isolated south pole, then I should get dy V equal to that source function. But I am getting 0. In magnetic, source and sinks do not exist. If you take a magnet and break it into two pieces, then each piece will act as a small magnet. You cannot say that one piece acts as north pole, another piece acts as south pole. That is not correct. So in magnetics, isolated poles do not exist. Lorentzian force experienced by a charge Q in electric field, F1 is E into Q. So this equation tells you that direction of force is same as the direction of electric field. Example, when you enter into the theater, you experience a force. If I assume you are a charge in the body, and in the theater there is a field, once you enter into the theater, you experience a force. So first part of Lorentzian says in an electric field, a force is experienced, that is E into Q. The second part, when a current carrying conductor is kept in the magnetic field, it experiences a force. Q into V cross B. When both the fields are there, it is Q into E plus V cross B. This equation is called Lorentzian equation. So in one of the IAS examination, he has given V and V, asked you to calculate E such that field is such that the force is E. In one of the examination, V and V are given, we are asked to find out E such that the net force is 0. So net force is 0, 0 by Q is 0. Therefore E is equal to minus of V cross B. Find out V cross B multiplied with minus 1. That should be the electric field, so that the net force will be 0. So you have two constants, one is scalar magnetic potential, other one is vector magnetic potential. For objective questions, vector magnetic potential is very important. Somehow very often it is there in the multiple choice. Definition of vector magnetic potential, very very important. So in electrostatics you had some potential V. Electric field is derivative of that potential. You take derivative of the electric potential, you get electric field. Similarly, derivative of magnetic potential should give you magnetic field. First they thought, they started with scalar magnetic potential, then they found the concept is not really useful or not correct. In electrostatic, charges are sources, charges are scalars, so resulting potential is scalar. But in magnetics, the sources are current elements. Current element is a vector. Therefore, magnetic potential must be vector. So Maxwell argued that magnetic potential must be vector because the corresponding source is a vector. Current element is a vector. So that's why he said derivative of magnetic potential gives magnetic field. So del cross A is B because cross product, the answer will be vector. A is a vector. B is also vector. So, last chapter we have seen electrostatic boundary conditions. Once you go through electrostatics, magnetics will be easy because magnetics is has the analogy, similarity with electrostatics. So, there Dn1 is Dn2, here Bn1 is Bn2. There Et1 is Et2, here H2 is H2. So, here Snell's law, tan theta 2 by tan theta 1, mu r 2 by mu r 1. So you remember the suffix must be same. What are suffix you have here? Same suffix here. Now INAN boundary, mu r of IN 1000, angle of incidence some 20 degrees, find out angle of emergence. So air means mu r is equal to 1. For other medium mu r will be given, one angle will be given, you have to calculate the other angle. So when two conductors are separated, two current carrying conductors separated, they will have force. If both the conductors carry current in the same direction, they attract. If they carry current in opposite direction, they repel. This you find in transmission lines. So in your lab, you can do this. instrument, if you keep two conductors carrying current in the same direction, after some time they will be like this because your force of attraction, they try to come together. So when two conductors carry current in opposite direction, they will be repelling. So if two conductors carry current in same direction, your force of attraction, opposite direction force of attraction. So that force 2 into 10 power minus 7 I1 I2 L by 5 E. So from this, what type of objective questions you will get? Force is proportional to I square. If I take a single phase line, whatever current flows in the forward conductor, same current flows in the return conductor. If current is doubled, what happens to the force? Force becomes 4 times I square. If I is doubled, force becomes 4 times. If the distance of separation is doubled, force gets half. Force is inversely proportional to the distance between the two conductors. So if the distance is doubled, the force will be half. So in one of the gate examination, he has asked, determine whether the field can represent a magnetic field. An equation is given, F is equal to xi minus yj, and he is asking whether it can represent magnetic field or not. So how do you proceed with that? There is an objective question, one field is given, F, some xi minus yj, determine whether that can represent a magnetic field. Magnetic field means directly equal to 0. Take divergence. If the answer is 0, it will be magnetic field. If the answer is not 0, it cannot represent a magnetic field. So that is how you find out whether the field is a magnetic field or not. So if the given field is magnetic field, which means divergence of F must be equal to 0. Next, dipole moment. What is dipole? A small current loop is called dipole. A circular current loop, a small circular current loop is called magnetic dipole. Dipole moment is current into area. So what will be the unit of M? The unit of M will be ampere meter square. Current is in amperes, area in meter square. So if you take iron, inside the iron lot of magnetic dipoles are there, they are randomly oriented. Then over the iron you have conductors and pass current. So when you pass current, the random dipoles will come to regular orientation. That is called magnetization. The shortcut form of magnetic polarization is magnetization. Unmagnetized state means magnetic dipoles are randomly oriented. Then when you pass current or when you apply magnetic field, all the magnetic dipoles will be oriented in one particular direction. That process is magnetization. So magnetization is magnetic dipole moment divided by volume, ampere meter square by meter cube. That will be ampere per meter. Ampere per meter. Unit of magnetization, ampere per meter. Amperes plus A is work done equal to MMF. MMF is N into I. In fields, we assume single conductor. If N is equal to 1, work done is current. So integral of H dot dl is equal to I. Amperes plus A is work done is equal to current. So when you go to the temple, around Hanuman you take one round. Around Ganeshan you take 3 rounds, so work done is 3i. Around Navagraha's work done is 9i. In general, if there are n number of gods, the total work done is n into n. So work done depends on number of currents and the current. So here you divide the area on both sides. This equation, if you divide by area, work done by area is current H, current by area is current X. Work done by area is current H, current by area is current density. So current H equal to J is Ampere's law. By its arts law says del V equal to 0. Scalar magnetic potential H is minus del V. Scalar electric potential. potential E equal to minus del V. If E equal to minus del V, H equal to minus del V. So you have to match A corresponds to 2, B corresponds to 1, C corresponds to, match the following, one side law, other side equation. You have to match the equation with the corresponding law. A corresponds to 2, B corresponds to 1, and C corresponds to 3. Third unit, what we have studied is Faraday's law or primary fields. We have to recollect the Oersted concept. Oersted says you take a magnetic needle nearer to a conductor. So if you take a magnetic needle nearer to a conductor, it gets different. When a magnetic needle is brought nearer to a conductor, it gets different. If current can produce magnetic field, why not magnetic field produce current in the conductor? Look at the great finding. The greatest finding is Faraday's law. Look at the way of thinking of Faraday. Faraday's thinking is converse of Oersted's statement. Oersted says the current carrying conductor produces magnetic field. If current can produce magnetic field, why not magnetic field produce current in the conductor? So when the flux linked by the coil changes with time, an EMF is induced, and if the circuit is closed, there will be a Faraday's law says EMF is d psi by dt. EMF is rate of change of flux. So that equation gives you curl E equal to minus dou V by dou V. So if you integrate on both sides, V is minus of integral of curl E dV. So sometimes in your examination, E will be given, they will ask you to find out V. E will be given, you are asked to find out V, find out curl E and then integrate, you get V. Sometimes you get a problem on Faraday DC generator. Very first kind of generator invented by Faraday. So EMF omega B A square by 2, omega is 2 pi n pi 60. Flux density will be given, radius will be given. You can use this formula omega B A square by 2, you can calculate the EMF. So this part is given by Faraday. Faraday says EMF is rate of change of flux. Lenz's law says this opposes the cause of the creation. Effect opposes the cause. Son fights with father, or daughter fights with mother for property. So like that in a generator, induced force opposes the applied force. In a motor, induced torque opposes load torque opposes the developed